for employees at a Queens hospital that's closing its doors after nearly three decades of service. Former reporter Rochelle Boone has the story.
It was a somber day for workers at Hollis-Wood Hospital as they said their goodbyes. Some let the tears flow while others kept their heads down as they left the privately owned psychiatric facility for the last time. More than 370 employees were laid off.
People are in shock. I think that people are, you know, reality is starting to hit. People are grieving.
It's pretty heartbreaking and to hear everybody's stories about how they can't find jobs and health insurance and things like that.
Many say they were blindsided by the hospital's closure, which was only announced 2 weeks ago. Dolores Jones worked here 27 years.
They just said, this is it. Came in to work on the 6th. They gave me a letter for the 12th. That was it.
Hospital officials say financial problems led to the closure of the 127-bed facility, which served both children and adults, including members of the military.
We have a lot of managed care patients, commercial insurance. The lengths of stay have generally gone down, so we have fewer days that patients are able to stay. Medicaid rates have remained frozen for several years while the cost of providing care has gone up. So things like that have affected.
Fell apart 3 weeks ago.
That pretty much was the final straw.
The hospital held a job fair to try to help staff members find other work. And while it worked out great for some, most are now unemployed.
It's heartbreaking. Are we going to get another job hearing that all these hospitals are closing? You know, that's the scary part.
Especially since this is now the 6th borough hospital to close in the last 10 years. In Queens, Rochelle Boone, New York One.
Staten Island Camp Counselor.